Farber, discoverer of the Action Board. Welcome to the third video in the Goal Setting Action Board series. The first video talked about why it's so important to have goals. Why do we need to set goals at all? And introduced you to the concept of an action board and why an action board is so much more effective than a vision board. The second video discussed the 8 key to achieve principles. The 8 principles that are necessary to achieve success in setting all your goals and seeing all your dreams come true. This video will discuss the 10 components that make up the action board. They're based on the 8 key to achieve principles. So if you haven't seen that video, I recommend go back there, watch that video, and then come and join us again to see the 10 components. Those components are important to make up every action board. Now, if you're not that creative, you're not that artistic, you don't have the time to spend putting a lot of pictures on a big board, you don't need to. An action board can be made in a notebook. It doesn't matter where you make it up. What matters is that it includes the 10 components, and it's based on the 8 key to achieve principles. So with that in mind, let's get started and learn about the components.
The first component is the dominator statement. Many of us set up New Year's resolutions and most of us forget about them after just a few weeks. Why is that? What's missing from a New Year's resolution is your deepest, sincerest personal values that inspire you to choose this goal in the first place. That's the dominator statement. It's your own personal motivating mission statement. It focuses your intentions. The dominator statement helps you set up your goal-directed behavior. You can establish a dominator statement in many different areas like family and home, adventure, educational, fitness, financial. So today, let's establish a value-based goal in something that you need to accomplish in athletics. So here are a few examples of some dominator statements. I'm going to train in some way every day so that I can be consistent. I'm going to get a college scholarship to save my parents' money and to give me more options in the future. I'm going to set my personal best time or personal best height or distance or weight or number of wins because I value the challenge and I want to make myself proud of me. The second component is the what. That's your specific goal. You need to add lots of details. What is valuable to you? What is your life missing? What do you want to do? And what do you want to be doing that so far you've only just dreamed about? What are your unspoken passions? Write this as a positive rather than a negative, because it's more motivating to work towards something than to run away from something. For example, by saying I want instead of I don't want. I want to spend more time training rather than I don't want to spend as much time doing online gaming. I want to get a scholarship rather than I don't want to pay for college. Now visualize your specific goal. For example, you want a college scholarship in your sport. Visualize what this would feel like. Just saying a scholarship, that's not good enough for this. A college scholarship in basketball by at least one university during my senior year in high school that will pay for at least half my tuition. That's a more complete description of a goal. The more details you provide in your description, the more information you give to your subconscious mind. And that means a greater ability to clarify your purpose, set up your dominoes, and take inspired action. Set your goals high, but not out of reach. Be optimistic, yet realistic. Have faith in your ability to conquer and succeed. Have faith in your ability to achieve greatness, because I know you can. Ask yourself, how will you know when you've achieved this goal? How are you going to know when you get there? Try to include measurable endpoints in your description. Numbers, percent, something that you can hold yourself accountable to. Here's some examples of what statements. I will lose 20 pounds. Or I will put on 10 pounds of muscle. I will get into great physical condition by working out at the gym at least 3 times per week and eating healthier food at home. I will take 20 seconds off my time. I will improve my free throws by 20%. The next component is the when. Vision boards that we spoke about don't involve timelines. For your action board, the when is essential. When are you going to complete this goal is an essential component of all action boards. Not setting a deadline or a timeline is one of the greatest reasons for people not achieving or even working toward their goal. A goal is a dream with a deadline. So when are you going to start it? When are you going to complete it? Identify exactly when you intend to make your goals and dreams come true. Try to divide your final goal into smaller bite-sized pieces with specific dates or timelines for each of the bites. You can break up your timeline into daily, weekly, or even monthly mini-goals. Again, make your timeline optimistic to challenge yourself, but also realistic. The next component is motivators. What is motivating you? Why do you care about this? Why is this goal so important? We've all had goals that we've given up on. What makes this one so special? Motivators are your driving force that keep you going when things get tough. They give you a boost, an uplifting shot of energy when we start to get goal fatigue. Motivators are Red Bull for the soul. Motivators are phrases or pictures that are derived from your values and your principles. Some examples would be pictures of famous athletes in similar sports, a picture of you on a podium, inspirational sayings that really speak to you, a picture of some colleges that you might want to attend, or a picture of your goal in numbers, like height or weight, time on a clock, a large bicep, a basketball going through a hoop. The fifth component is commitments. These are specific action steps that you're going to take to achieve your goal. Commitment means staying loyal to what you said you were going to do long after the mood you set it in has left you. How specifically are you going to make this happen? It's your personal business plan. Without commitments, there are only hopes and dreams. This is where you further detail what you plan to do to realize the goal. Commitment is what separates resilient athletes from quitters. It's what separates the men from the boys and the women from the girls. When you're committed, you are driven to achieve success. Here are some examples of commitments. I will not eat fast foods more than twice a week. I will eat healthy food and turn down junk food at least once every day. I will do something that is related to my sport at least once per day. I will get my homework done before 10 p.m. so I have better workouts in the morning. The sixth component is challenges. Problems are debilitating. Things that we consider situations, those should be avoided. But challenges, those are empowering. They're often blessings in disguise. How will you rise to the challenge? When we identify future challenges, it helps you plan for a variety of possibilities that might come up. Doing this increases the chance that these obstacles will become opportunities. Make a realistic list of challenges and obstacles that you are likely to face along your journey. Think about how you're going to rise to face these challenges. How are you going to overcome these obstacles? As an Olympic marathon runner said, sometimes the moments that challenge us the most define us. As my martial arts hero Bruce Lee said, do not pray for an easy life. Pray for the strength to endure a difficult one. Challenges can be good. Here are some examples. When my friends and I go out, we end up at McDonald's and I eat junk food. So how will you rise to the challenge to face that? When I get home from school, I open my computer and see who's on Facebook. After dinner, I like to watch TV and I don't always get my homework done. When I train hard for a few days, my muscles get sore, and then I want to take a few days off for my workouts. The seventh component is called strengths. We all have talents and strengths. What talents and strengths and abilities would help you with this particular goal? Using the divine visualization process, think of which talents and strengths would best accomplish this task. There are some general strengths like perseverance, determination, resilience, passion, and those things will help you achieve most goals. There are other talents like wisdom, communication, the ability to jump, being agile, speed, flexibility, and reading people that will be more beneficial for specific certain types of goals. So which of these talents do you believe you possess? What are your strengths and talents and abilities, and how will you use them to accomplish this goal? Try to come up with your top 5 to 10 strengths. The next component is called reinforcements. In addition to your talents and strengths, you have other resources that will help you achieve the goal. Those are your reinforcements. Reinforcements might be finances that you might need to make purchases or other material objects that are going to be useful to accomplish this task. What special items do you have that might come in useful to complete your goal? Again, use your visualizations to get a clear picture of what other things you might need to get started and to help you drive your goal to completion. Now, who are the people in your life that will also play important roles? When we practice positive psychology principles of communication, gratitude, and hope, you're going to attract other people and be surrounded by positive, optimistic people. You have friends, family, neighbors, teachers, coaches, trainers, mentors, counselors, preachers, rabbis that may be able to assist you in completing this goal. Those people are going to be a source of inspiration, a great source of information, and if you're lucky, they'll also be a source of perspiration. Ninth component is called action. Action is both a principle and a component. Vision boards focus on visualizing the outcome and pretending to live in the future. The action board focuses on visualizing the process and getting off your butt to make it happen now. You can make it happen. Without action, your goals are just wishes. Your dreams will only remain wishes. Action is what moves the vision board into the next century of goal achievement tools. Look at your action board and visualize what you will do each day to move forward on your goal. Taking just a few minutes to focus on your board will reestablish your intention and put you in a better mental place to visualize the process. How will you take action? Accomplishing your goal won't happen by chance. It's a conscious decision, and you have the ability and talent to do this. Every day that you say to yourself you want this goal to be accomplished, take some degree of inspired action to make it happen. The last component is dominations. When you integrate the key to achieve principles of dominoes and the positive psychology principle of celebrations, you get the component of dominations. As you recall, dominoes are all of your commitments you plan to do, all of the challenges and mini goals that you've set up. What does it mean to dominate? It means that you've knocked down one of your dominoes. That means there will be frequent mini celebrations. It could be several times in a day. Every time you climb a flight of stairs instead of taking the elevator, turn down a milkshake at Burger King, eat a healthy meal, go to bed at a decent hour, complete your homework, stretch in the morning, finish your workout, or successfully shoot that free throw, you have dominated. There are thousands of examples. You can take a Sharpie and put check marks on your board. You can print out a list of your dominoes and accomplishments and cross them off as you go. You can put really cool stickers on your board. The specifics for how you're going to show all your dominations, that's up to you. The important part is not to ignore your successes. That doesn't mean bragging about them to all your friends, but realize that you've done it. You should be proud of what you're accomplishing. Dominating your goal is empowering. It's inspiring. It's energizing, and it will energize you to pursue your goal with enthusiasm and passion while improving your motivation and your self-esteem. Remember, maturity comes when you stop making excuses and start making changes.
This video on goal setting and the action board. But don't just set goals, achieve them. Elite athletes do this, and you can do it. You can control your destiny, and you can control your goal. You have the motivation, you have the ability, the talents, the strengths to do it. Now make it happen. Establish your goals based on your values. Visualize the path. Set up your dominoes and then knock them down one at a time as you dominate your goals. Celebrate each achievement, each mini goal. Every time you rise to a challenge, acknowledge it. Build your self-esteem. You're important. You can do this. I hope this video has inspired you to follow the 8 Key to Achieve principles for success and to create your own action.
Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Do it for your people, do it for your pride. Never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.